Hi, my name is Kathy Baldwin, and I'm the current FSHP Legal and Regulatory Chair. This is a brief update on PBM for hospital pharmacists. If you're like me, a couple of years ago, I asked, what is a PBM? And a PBM is a pharmacy benefit manager. The largest of all PBMs are Express Scripts, CVS Caremark, and OptumRx. And these three PBMs fill about 75% of all outpatient prescriptions in the United States. At one time, they were claims adjudicators, and they served the focus of making sure the pharmacy received payment from the insurer. However, they have morphed into something totally different than what they originally did. And they became very wealthy. And it's very easy to see on this slide, if you look at the slide by the coloring, you see that the insurance companies and the PBMs have merged and they become one company. So Aetna and CVS Caremark merged and Cigna and Express Scripts merged. I'd like to thank Adam Fine at Drug Channels Institute for this wonderful slide and all the information that he puts out. And by the way, when they merged, that became known as vertical integration, as you can see as you look at each one of these by color. So the pharmacy benefit managers are the middlemen of the prescription drug chain between the insurance company and the patient. So how did they get really wealthy? Well, one of their tactics are rebates. And you can see here where Mylan brought EpiPens to market at a cost of $274 for two pens. And by the time the PBMs were done adding on rebates, the patient cost was $608. Not necessarily that's what they paid, but that would become the number by which copays would be determined. But if they were paying out of pocket, you can easily see how the price rebates increase drug therapy prices. This slide is brought to us by Pharmacists United for Truth and Transparency at truthrx.org. Another one of the practices is that pharmacy benefit managers have basically made drug pricing not discernible. So there's no really discrete value for drugs. And so if you look at this slide from GoodRx, and this is for generic rosuvastatin 20 milligrams, the prices are all over the place. And you can see the cheapest price is $9.90. And then it says at the bottom, $187 is the retail price. So PBMs have contributed to this. And I think of this as a way to explain spread pricing. And allow me to give you a personal story. I went to my independent pharmacist and it cost my independent pharmacist $2 to fill my prescription, to obtain the prescription to dispense to me. So it was a $2 prescription for a 30-day supply. Then I needed to go to a chain that my insurance company prefers. And that was, when I talked to the pharmacist, they were billing my insurance company $150 for that prescription that cost my independent pharmacist $2, and I paid a $5 copay. Well, I get a 90-day supply. So they're billing my insurance $450. I'm paying $15 copay for what really costs $6 to obtain by the independent pharmacist. That is the definition of spread pricing. Of course, you can see as drug costs go up, and this is really why we as hospital pharmacists and health system pharmacists need to be keen and tuned into this, because patients cannot afford high copays or high out-of-cost pockets, which is what PBMs are doing, increasing costs. So the Supreme Court in December of 2020 ruled 8-0 that states can reform PBMs. And in Florida, a group of pharmacists got together and they audited themselves and then sent that information to the legislators in the 2020 legislative session. So the legislators sent that to Medicaid because it was all about Medicaid claims. And a report was done called the Milliman Report. And the results of the Milliman Report were that PBMs cost Florida Medicaid system $113 million in prescription markups, and nearly $90 million were due to the spread costs. So the Milliman Report has been adopted into a couple of bills in Florida called PBM bills, and their recommendation in these bills, because of the report, is to outlaw this practice of spread pricing and to also outlaw steering. Steering occurs when a patient fills a prescription at an independent pharmacist and the PBM calls the patient up and says, we see the claim here that you went to Joe's pharmacy, but we own a pharmacy and we think you should be using our mail service pharmacy. And we will incentivize you to use that mail service pharmacy. So the Milliman Report recommends outlawing spread pricing and outlawing steering. Thank you for so much for this brief PBM update. Thank you.